All right, folks. So I am no expert in marketing, but I do want to talk a little bit about brand association because I think it's relevant. It's really relevant now that we have a Democratic Party primary and a general election coming up. So ask yourself this. Why is the sales for Corona beer declining currently? I mean, that's obvious, right? It's because people associate Corona beer with coronavirus, and that's really, really bad for the brand. Okay, that's a non-political example. But moving on to a political example, think back to 2015, 2016. Why did none of the Republicans who were running for president back then ever bring up George W. Bush? Never mention the fact that they were from the Bush wing of the Republican Party. Even Jeb Bush wouldn't really bring up the fact that George W. Bush was his brother. Like, why was that a thing that happened? It's because George W. Bush was politically toxic. So now, fast forward to present day, why are Democrats still associating with a brand that is politically toxic? Republicans knew that they had to shake the image of Bush and Republican, right? If they wanted a shot at beating Democrats. So why are Democrats not doing the same for Hillary Clinton? Because just having her associated with the Democratic Party brings down the aggregate Democratic Party because she is deeply disliked, deeply unpopular, and for very good reasons. So you think if they want to win, and I'm not sure that they do, not sure that they're serious about winning, they would do everything in their power to stay away from Hillary Clinton, but yet Democrats haven't learned from that mistake. And this isn't like some new thing to the 2020 election. In 2018, Andrew Gillum was campaigning with Hillary Clinton and Debbie Wasserman Schultz, like some of the most politically toxic figures in American politics. So Democrats, for whatever reason, they haven't learned about brand association and how it hurts them to be associated with a toxic brand. So now Hillary Clinton, like, she can make her own decisions, right? She has a documentary and people are interviewing her again for whatever reason, and it's on Hulu. I haven't watched it yet because I don't hate myself that much. She also has a podcast coming out before the general election, so that'll be interesting. And, you know, it's fine if she wants to do her own thing. Nobody can control her. She can do whatever she wants. I would prefer that she goes away, but she's not going to go away. She's made that very clear. But what matters is how Democrats and the media respond. And we know a lot of people in mainstream media, they are Democrats, right? They're Democratic Party establishment loyalists. They'll pretend to be objective and neutral, and they won't say that, but in actuality, they are. So if they cared about Democrats, if Democrats cared about Democrats, why are we still taking anything that Hillary Clinton says seriously? And I want to give you an example. So Hillary Clinton was talking to Fareed Zakaria on CNN, and she was giving him advice on who can beat Donald Trump. I don't know what to say, but take a look, because this is a real thing that happened.
If Bernie Sanders is the Democratic nominee, will you campaign for him?
I will support the nominee of the Democratic Party.
But will you campaign for him?
I don't know if he would ask me to campaign for him, Fareed, because I have no idea what he is thinking about for a general election campaign. As I've said many times, I do not think he's our strongest nominee against Donald Trump.
Is that an endorsement of Joe Biden?
I'm not endorsing.
There's nobody left.
Well, I mean, I guess that's true. There isn't anybody left. But I think what Joe's victories on Super Tuesday showed is that he is building the kind of coalition that I had, basically. It's a broad-based coalition. I finished, you know, most of the work I needed to do for the nomination on Super Tuesday, and then it kind of lingered on. And I think Joe is on track to doing exactly the same thing, putting together a coalition of voters who are energized.
Okay, so some of you might have missed this, and I can forgive you if you forgot, because it's been a couple of years now. But back in 2016, Hillary Clinton was the Democratic Party's nominee, and she lost to Donald Trump. Yeah, many of you might not know this. But yet, we're bringing her on mainstream media, and she's telling us who she thinks is the strongest against Donald Trump. And we're not just laughing in her face. Fareed Zakaria didn't, like, burst out into tears, laughing hysterically at what she had to say. She literally said, Joe Biden is building the kind of coalition that I had, basically. putting together a coalition of people who are energized. Am I, like, alone here? Am I in the Twilight Zone? She lost to Donald Trump. Anything she says with regard to electoral politics and strategy is to not be taken seriously, is to be disregarded at a minimum. But what's more important is that Democrats disassociate from Hillary Clinton because, again, politically toxic. If Donald Trump gets to run against Joe Biden, he is going to have a field day because Joe Biden is weak. But imagine how successful Donald Trump's strategy will be if he can tie the 2020 Democratic Party to Hillary Clinton still. I mean, we saw how effective he was with Crooked Hillary. So if he can tie Joe Biden to Hillary Clinton, who people very much still associate with the Democratic Party, which is a problem, I mean, Trump cruises to re-election and the Democrats still are delegitimized. So it's just, honestly, like, I watch these interviews and I'm shocked. Why is anyone listening to what Hillary Clinton has to say? You can ask for her opinion about fucking television and video games. Maybe she's playing Fortnite. I don't know. But if you're going to ask for her opinion on strategy, what do you say to that? What do you say to that? Now, I do want to show you a clip from her on ABC because she, this was on Super Tuesday, she attacked Bernie Sanders. Again, she usually does this before a very important election. She did this before Iowa. She attacked him before Super Tuesday, kind of pile on. And listen to what she had to say here, because it honestly is astonishing that she is this bold to say something like this after she lost to Donald Trump.
In the campaign, in the documentary, you talk about his campaign from 2016, and you call it, quote, just baloney, and I feel so bad that people got sucked into it. Do you still feel that way now?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, you know, that was my authentic opinion then. It's my authentic opinion now. You know, here's one of the saddest things happening right now. The House of Representatives under Democratic leadership has passed 400 bills on really important issues, everything from health care to economic security to election security. It just goes on and on. Does anybody know that, Lindsay? Of course not. Nobody knows that. Change is hard. It's not glamorous. It doesn't fit into a soundbite. And yet the people who were elected in 2018 are down there doing the people's work. And I just think we ought to be more understanding and realistic about what it takes to get change in this big, complicated, pluralistic democracy of ours. And it's not easy, but boy, is it ever worth it. And I just want to make sure that voters know what can be done if they give the White House back to the Democrats.
I mean, I don't know what to say anymore. I don't know what to say anymore. She said, I just want the voters to know what can be done if they give the White House back to the Democrats. You don't tell them what can be done. You didn't tell them what can be done. Joe Biden is not telling them what can be done. And even your wording there is problematic. I just want voters to know what can be done. The fact that you're not citing specific policies shows how out of touch you are. Listen, voters, if you vote for Democrats, I promise you so many good things will be done. We're not going to talk about anything that we can do. We will repeatedly tell you that we can't have Medicare for all, we can't have free college. But just know, there's going to be such awesome things that will be done, but you've got to elect us first. Maybe we'll tell you some of it, maybe we won't, but we're going to do such awesome things. It's going to be so fucking cool. They're so out of touch. She also says the House of Representatives passed 400 bills. Does anybody know that? No, but whose fault is that? The Democratic Party. Just like Republicans, the Democratic Party has their own corporate media propaganda wing. When Republicans want something to be known by voters, they say it and Fox News says it. Now, we know that MSNBC and the Democratic Party establishment, they use the same talking points. I don't believe they're coordinating. I think that a lot of this is just they exist in that same DC bubble, but they use the same talking points. If Democrats wanted voters to know that they passed 400 bills, they would fucking know that. but because people don't know, is a failure on you. It's a failure on you. So Hillary Clinton is so painfully out of touch, and it's just astonishing to me that mainstream media continues to bring her on. And Hillary Clinton, she's not self-aware, right? She's not aware of the fact that voters dislike her a lot, so much so that they opted for Trump over her. But still, she's not aware. But Nancy Pelosi's got to be aware. Chuck Schumer has got to be aware. People in the Democratic Party have got to know, we're going to lose if voters still think that Hillary Clinton is associated with the Democratic Party. She's that toxic of a figure. So just the fact that we are parading her around on television and asking her what she thinks it's going to take to beat Donald Trump should make everyone's head explode. She doesn't know what it's going to take to beat Donald Trump because she lost to Donald Trump. And now it's going to be harder to beat Donald Trump because he is the incumbent. Incumbents always have that advantage. So now, because of her incompetence, it's going to be harder to beat Donald Trump, and we're potentially nominating someone who is more out of touch than her. At least she was a woman, so you can say, well, I'm excited about electing the first woman president. At least she had charisma. She can at least say what she was thinking, right? She was articulate. She has a degree of charisma. And now we're putting up Joe Biden, possibly. The Democratic Party is just a lost cause. It's a lost cause. And I don't even know what the right word is. Like, we need a new adjective to describe what's happening because nothing really does it justice. It's not disappointing. It's not shocking. It's just something new, right? That they never will learn their lesson. And hypothetically speaking, if Biden's the nominee and he loses to Trump, do you honestly think that they're going to do any soul searching in 2024, 2028? No. They're never going to change the same people who got us to this point. With Donald Trump as president, Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, Joe Biden, they're still going to be saying the same things. The media will still parrot what they say, and we will be in this predicament where we are getting steamrolled by Republicans because at least they know how to win. They're disgusting, they're ruthless, but they win. Democrats don't know how to do that. They don't know how to do that. And anytime Hillary Clinton talks about electoral politics and gives us her advice, she's hurting the party because she's not very liked. The only person more disliked than her in politics was Donald Trump, and she couldn't even beat him. So forgive me for not caring what Hillary Clinton has to say about Bernie Sanders or the Democratic Party. As far as I'm concerned, she is permanently discredited, and I don't care about what she has to say about politics. She can talk about whatever she wants to on her podcast, but it's really our responsibility. It's incumbent on us to ignore her and make fun of her whenever she talks about politics because she is discredited. You can't beat Trump. Don't want to hear what you have to say in 2020 about beating Trump. It's as simple as that. The fact that I even have to say this shows in, you know, what a bad state of affairs we're in currently.
I used to say the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result.
Mm-hmm.